So we're back on this subject. Today is December 29th, 2015. The subject we're back on is emotional abuse. I talked to my therapist yesterday about it. I even just talked to Lori right now, my boss. Lori has experienced emotional abuse, just had another trigger on Sunday, as she called it, as she talked to her ex-husband, the man that used to emotionally abuse her in the marriage, and a lot of those words have stuck with her. So when he was talking to her and belittling her on Sunday over the phone regarding their shared daughter, she went into a meltdown mode, and she couldn't get out of it very quickly. And she's better now, 48 hours later. She's able to talk and deal with it, but she still has triggers. She still has things that bother her regarding that relationship. And, I mean, from what he has basically damaged in her mind. So the trick becomes, how do I communicate to my husband that I'm being emotionally abused by him? And the therapist I talked to yesterday thinks that that's a really harsh word, so not to come off sounding like that, you know, on the attack, but maybe give an example of when you say things like this, I feel like this, and have him see that the way he's talking to me or the way he's treating me is not acceptable. And even if I was to tell him that the therapist says this, and this, he would think that I'm painting the picture that things are terrible, and things are not terrible all of the time. And then you get into the details of it. Is he really controlling me, or am I allowing him to control me? Am I so used to the emotional abuse that I received from my father with his tantrums and his yelling and his explosions that I almost expect that from my husband, and that's my daddy issues? There's like so many little fine details that I really don't know if I'm being emotionally abused or if I'm creating the emotional abuse in my mind. And that's what therapists have agreed with him about. That's what Jim has said that I'm doing. Jim has never come out and flat out admitted that he's controlling me or manipulating me. But I do feel controlled and manipulated, so how am I, don't know. There's so much gray inside of that. It's not so black and white. There's a lot of little fine details that need to be sorted out. And either I need to just stop thinking he's controlling me, or he needs to stop controlling me. It's not so simple. I think it's I need to speak up and stop allowing the controlling, whether he's doing it to me or I'm doing it to myself. I need to observe it. I need to recognize it. I need to be aware of it. I need to acknowledge it. Acknowledge that this is a moment where I feel like I'm being controlled. Honey, this is a moment where I feel like I'm being controlled. Are you telling me what I need to do, or am I expecting you to tell me what I need to do? Who's doing the controlling here? Me or him? I'm self-sabotaging. I think I am. I think I'm self-sabotaging. Wow, no wonder why I'm screwed up. I think I am. I mean, I think I let him control me. I think a part of him likes it and a part of him doesn't. So I don't know. It's so messy. It's not so clean cut and dry. Eureka, it's not. Wow. So done thinking about this anymore. I just want to sit on it right now instead of stop talking about it. I just want to accept right now that it's messy, and I need to talk to him about it really soon.